Hi friends, it's Wesley. Look, it's four of the same 720p video on a grid. Okay, they aren't exactly the same. This footage was shot with my phone, but three of them have been denoised using FFmpeg. Let's take a closer look and see what's going on here. On the far left, you can see some noisy low-light areas of the original footage. The very popular nlmeans filter is handling the noise like a champ. The only catch is that the nlmeans filter tends to convert HD footage at less than 1 frame per second. Clearly that's a problem if you're shooting longer scenes. The lesser known owdenoise looks even better though. Sadly, this one takes about twice as long as nlmeans, so it's out of the question. BM3D is also quite highly regarded. It doesn't look quite as good as the first two, but it renders about twice as fast as nlmeans for me, so about 2 frames per second. Vaguedenoiser looks pretty good here and finishes quite quickly. Promising. dctdnoiz doesn't seem to be doing much with its default settings, so we'll simply move on. fftdnoiz is certainly smearing that noise around, but it might also be smearing some detail as well. Being sort of a low-pass filter, this should likely be used sparingly. The atadenoise filter is very highly regarded in video circles online. It's super quick and produces reasonable results. You can probably just stop watching this video if you want to be as enlightened as the fine folks on Reddit. I'm assuming you want to ascend to a higher plane of cell phone video editing though, so let's continue. For those of you that stuck around, you've already been rewarded with HQDN3D. What sets it apart from atadenoise is that it's both spatial and temporal, while ATA is only temporal with no motion compensation. As far as I can tell, it looks about as good as the first two CPU hogs we looked at, if not better. Let's compare. nlmeans. owdenoise. Okay, this footage isn't that noisy, so let's take things to the next level. Here's a 1080p video of my hand, shot in a dark corner, with my phone's horrid stabilization mode enabled. Look at all that noise. Now I'm going to be quiet and just let you take a look at the same footage through each filter from fastest to slowest. Okay, wait a minute. nlmeans and owdenoise both look more noisy than some of the faster filters. What the heck? Let's combine three of the fastest filters and see what we get. Wow, maybe we can get away with only two. Now that looks pretty good to me, but the video encoding nerds of Stack Overflow are not happy yet. Several such nerds suggest adding sharpening to reduce the blur these denoise filters produce. Let's use the Stack Overflow suggested unsharp filter luma amount of 2.5. And as expected, that looks pretty bad. Even in the documentation for FFmpeg, it's recommended to choose a value between negative 1.5 and 1.5. So let's roll with 0.5 to dial that back a hair. Okay, that looks pretty good. We've looked at a lot, so let's take a step back and compare our results to the original footage and nlmeans, which is considered state of the art. Here's the original. nlmeans. FFT, ATA, and HQDN3D. nlmeans. ATA and HQDN3D. nlmeans. ATA and HQDN3D plus an unsharp filter. So what have we learned? Well, if you're the type of person to be shooting cell phone video in poor lighting and trying to denoise it, you probably aren't going to want to wait for nlmeans or owdenoise to smooth out your noisy footage. You may, however, find that combining fast filters like atadenoise, HQDN3D, or fftdnoiz does just what you want it to. Further combining these with an unsharp filter can produce very reasonable results. In the show notes, I've written out an FFmpeg example you can take and try in your own footage. Depending on the resolution, you may want to change these values though. Thanks again for watching, let me know if you found this video useful, and see you next time.